Good afternoon, everyone. Steve Georgia here from Allendale's Trading Floor. It's September 19th. Little different look at the markets today. The last few days, we've seen sharply lower moves, and today, higher. Corn up 16 and a half, beans up 29 and a half, with wheat up 18. So catching a bit of a bounce, a little bit of a rebound here today. Corn went right up to last week's lows at that 759 area. We settled pretty close to that, and then beans tried to jump back a little higher as well, up about 29 and a half, but still technically not breaking anything. We could end up seeing the beans find some resistance up around that 1690 level, if we can get back up there. But on the downside, areas that you have to watch as well is that 1630. So continue watching that. The trend has been broken this week so far for beans, and we need to get back above the day that we had that limit down move. We need to get back above that high in order to really keep that trend intact at this point. The wheat market did find some strength. That was kind of back and forth today. There was talks out there that we did have Iraq come in and buy some more Russian wheat. And the last several times that we have heard stuff like that, we've seen big purchases of Russian wheat, the markets reacted friendly. So wheat, once again, jumping up with news of that. I guess the trade is expecting to see Russia halt exports or do something with their exports as these purchases continue. Are we running out of Russian wheat? I don't know. But the market is friendly once we get information like that. Something else that came out today, USDA is going to change the time that they release the reports for the grains. So the cattle and hogs, as far as livestock, they're not going to change those. Those reports are still going to come out at 2 o'clock. But as far as when they release these reports for grains, we're looking at 11 o'clock Central Time. So the market will be trading and will continue to trade through the reports. But they are changing the release time. So we're changing those to 11 o'clock Central Time. And we'll see how that does reflect the market and maybe the volume of the market as well. But that will be a change. So look for that here on these next reports. Some of the other markets today, the dollar down about 17 cents. So we've seen a recovery in the dollar the last couple days. Today, down. So with the dollar being down, it did give a boost to the grains. But it did not give any help to the energy complex. Crude oil down $3.30, down more than $7 this week already. So we continue to break. We did break down below $92 a barrel. As I mentioned yesterday, we've got to watch that $90 level. If we take that out and close below 90 bucks, technically that does not look good. We could see some further declines yet in crude oil if that is the case. But a very sharp break so far this week, and doesn't look like they're taking that they're easing off of that as well. So they're continuing to break back on the energies. As far as the cattle markets, we were up about 7 cents, October at 126.47. We were down earlier in the day. We ended up fighting back. Box beef was great once again. Choice up $1.18. Select up 102, so continuing this stronger path here that we've seen over the last several days and looking pretty strong. Cash market, we're still looking for cash cattle. We've got offers right now, 128, 129. Still looking for cash to trade about a dollar higher this week. We also got some, we've got some of the estimates out for cattle on feed, which will be on Friday. The big thing there, placements are looking about 6% lower. That may be more supportive for that January to April time frame as far as cattle if we do end up seeing those lower placements. Hogs today, 90 cents higher, 75 even there for the October contract. Strong again. Cash market looks like it may have turned around. So we had the Iowa-Minnesota prices here at midday up another $3.16. The cash market looking stronger right now, as I mentioned. But we could see some more upside here from these levels. One thing that that we had put out here today and that we're talking about is just looking at the the lows that we usually put in here this time frame, we typically get about an 18-day bounce. So we get a rally for about 18 days. Now, this is the cash market, not the futures. The futures right now are sitting at a higher level than the cash, but we may see in this cash market turn right now, we may have a couple weeks here of good prices and stronger cash markets, which could end up taking the futures a little higher here from these levels as well. So look for that for the coming weeks. But as I mentioned, typically when we see that cash market bottom, we get about an 18-day rally from this point. So give us a call with any questions that you have. You can reach us here, 800-262-7538, or check us out online at allendale-inc.com. Hope you guys had a good day today, and we'll talk to you tomorrow. Take care.